Welcome. I'd like to start out today's session by telling a story. And it's a story that you've probably heard before. It is the story about the old man and the horse. And it's a story that is a teaching about living into uncertainty or living into a time of non-judgment of what is. So it goes like this. Once upon a time, there was an old man who had a beautiful white horse. And in the small village where he was living, all the villagers said, "Oh, you have such a beautiful horse. It's worth so much. It is such a good thing." And the old man said, "Yes, but don't be too quick to judge. I have this horse, but we don't know. We'll see. I do have a horse. Don't know. We'll see." Well, as things should pass, the horse one day was not in the stable. It was gone. And the villagers came up to the old man and said, "Oh, this is awful. This is a terrible thing. You will never be able to run your farm without your horse. What an awful, awful, bad thing." And the old man said, "Don't know. We'll see." And so it passed that the next day, the horse returned. And not only did the horse return, but the horse returned with 12 more horses along with it. They penned them in, and he had now 13 horses. And the villagers came to him and said, "Oh, this is such great news. This is wonderful. Now you have 13 horses. And the old man stepped back and said, "Yes, I have 13 horses. Don't know. We'll see." Well, as it should pass, the old man, who only had one son who was helping him run the farm, his one son was breaking in the horses, and there was an accident. One of the wild horses threw his son to the ground, breaking his leg. The villagers came in and they said, "Oh no, what a horrible thing, your only son with a broken leg. How will you ever farm?" And the old man said, "Don't know. We'll see." Well, as things should come to pass, there was a war that was started, and the villagers were, all the able-bodied young men were taken off to war, sure to be killed. And the villagers came up to the old man and said, because his son had a broken leg, he was no longer an able-bodied soldier, so they didn't take him. And the villagers said to him, "Oh, this is such a wonderful thing that your son broke his leg. He is not taken to war, sure to death." And the old man said, "Don't know. We'll see." And such is the lesson of this time, to be practicing, don't know, we'll see. So letting yourself close your eyes and drop into the breath, into the belly center. Slowing yourself down and letting the breath become a practice of don't know. With the inhale, letting the thoughts rise, and with the exhale, letting them go. letting yourself start with the breath now of in a seated position. Still, we're going to bring the breath. So we bring the arms up with the inhale. Bringing the palms together as we draw the hands down to the heart center with the exhale. Inhaling with arms outreached, opening, receiving. And then exhaling arms back down. And the movement is inhaling, letting all the questions of everything come into the mind. Exhaling, let go into the heart. Inhaling, reaching forward, opening to receiving. Exhaling, letting go. Try this three more times, just inhaling up. Exhaling into the heart, letting go. Inhaling, arms forward, receiving, open to outcome. Exhaling, don't know. Inhaling up. Exhaling to the heart. Opening. Exhaling, let go. Last time, inhaling up. Down to the heart. Opening to receive. And letting go. Just closing your eyes again, just receiving already the difference in your body now. Setting an intention for your own practice in this moment. Letting go. All right, now we're gonna start by standing and doing some warm up to be able to get into our bodies even more and have them ready for the practice. So you can see over here that I've got a certain number of props. I've got my blankets and my blocks if you need blocks, and ball and roller if you have them handy. And also I have my little squash ball. If you have these props, you can use them. If you don't, I'm gonna show you variations on what we're doing so that you don't need them, okay? So we're gonna start out actually with the ball. If you have the little ball, that is the one I just showed you, the squash ball. And for most of you who have been to my classes before, you know the routine of the ball, so you can do that. Or I'm going to show you a new one, a new kind of warm-up for the feet and bringing your awareness to your groundedness by doing a kind of a step that is around the clock. Okay, so we're gonna start with the right foot. I'm mirroring you, so this is my left. And we're just gonna step, imagine that you're in the middle of a clock face. And so in front of you is 12, and then behind you is 6. And we're going to step forward so that you can kind of gently step into the right foot, into the 12, 2 times. And then we're gonna go to the 1, 2 times. And then we're gonna go out to the 2, 2 times, and then out to the 3. And so we're gonna continue 2 steps to each one of the numbers that are on your clock that is around your body. And what we're doing here is just showing, or slowly kind of introducing a different kind of movement through the foot, waking it up, okay? Once you get to six, we're gonna switch feet and step back with the left onto six. And then over to seven and to eight and out to nine. And let this be just a time for you to start to, you can hear I have a little snap, crackle, pop as my ankle and my legs and knees are starting to get warmed up to the idea of moving. A lot of us have been sitting for a long time in these days. So bringing your movement is so important. All right, we're gonna start again, just going around the clock and waking things up. 12, and one, and two, and out to the side, three, and four, and five. Getting yourself warmed up a little bit more, and six. Switching feet, and back, six, and seven, and eight. This is something that you can do anywhere at any time during your day, whether it's just shifting gears between Zoom meetings, or it's when you're doing other tasks, all right, like brushing your teeth or washing your face. All right, now just feeling that in your body, bring your feet so that they're parallel, hip distance apart, and we're going to start by rolling and opening up the ankles, rolling out, and then rolling in. And then rolling onto the top of the foot. And then switching to the other side. So out to the outer circle, waking the ankle up. And then in. And then onto the top of the foot. And waking things up, we'll progress up to the knees. So circling the knees around, saying hello. And noticing as you do this how the weight is shifting from side to side around onto all four corners of the feet. And then circle around the other direction. Just warming things up. Softening and becoming aware of the breath and letting yourself drop down into the breath a little bit more. As you circle up, and let's widen the stance just a little bit more to shoulder width apart and circle around the hips. Now I'd like for you to imagine it like you're inside of an inner tube. And as you are inside this inner tube that you're able to push up against the edge of it inside. So you're able to feel that full circular range of movement through the pelvis. Let's go the other direction, circling around the other way, waking things up in the hips and lower back. Yeah, there might be a little bit of holding in there, so we want to just let this start to soften and open. And then maybe tilting the tailbone under and back, kind of like you're cinching your tail under between your legs and then out back behind you. Just getting some movement in through the pelvis and feeling the movement there so that you understand where the tailbone rests when it's straight down underneath you as opposed to out or tucked under, okay? All right, next we're gonna twist the spine a little bit. So we're gonna just shift the weight over to your left foot, swinging the left arm in front, and then over to the right and right arm, just shifting the weight back and forth from side to side as your arms swing, gently percussing onto the rib cage as you let the arms just flop around. And then also giving yourself a little bit more of a twist by gazing over the shoulder as you're twisting. So you're giving yourself a little bit more of a ringing out of the spine, twisting through and ringing out. Yes. And we're also gently percussing that area where the adrenals live, which our adrenals for many of us have been a little bit overstimulated lately. So letting that enter into and gently remind those adrenals get to let go right now. Let go. All right. Now we're going to rotate the arms, shoulders back, starting with leading with the shoulders and then alternating shoulder roll. And then leading from the elbows, letting yourself feel that a little bit more in that underarm, shoulder girdle, maybe even side seams as you lift up and let the movement come through the wrists, lengthening back and down. And then let the movement come all the way from the fingertips all the way back. So you're really feeling that side seam stretch each time all the way back into a back crawl. All right, and then we're gonna switch the direction. So over and forward, front crawl, and reaching from the fingertips, then reaching from the wrists, and then reaching from the elbows, and then reaching from the shoulder blades and shoulders. All right, let's just lift the shoulders up and drop them down. And lift the shoulders up and drop them down. And one more time, lift the shoulders up and drop them down. All right, now let's place the hands behind interlaced fingers and behind the neck, just gently cupping and supporting the back of the skull. And then we're gonna let the chin drop down, circling the head and neck, first over to one side, lengthening through the front of the neck, and dropping the ear toward the shoulder on the other side. So the movement here is not huge. Just think of it as gently softening and finding the edge of the circle that is your neck, next range of motion for today. And then finding a place where there's a nice stretch. Hanging out with that stretch for a breath cycle, maybe softening as you let go into the exhale. And then circling around the other direction. And just letting your elbows kind of extend out a little bit farther. That can give you a bit more of a stretch through the front of the body. And again, finding a place of stretch. So finding a place where your neck really likes to have a little extra elongation. You can even use your hands to gently elongate or lengthen through the back of the neck as you're stretching. And then coming back to center. Release the hands and then let yourself feel the length of the back of the neck and the length of the spine through the crown of the head. We're gonna do a couple more breathing exercises to help open up through the rest of the body. And the first is the breath of joy. Now the breath of joy is a movement of inhaling arms forward, inhaling arms out, inhaling arms up, and then the exhale is a swing forward. Arms come down on either side, and then we come back up for three inhales again. One, two, and three, and then swinging down. Okay, so you join me. And it's good to have an exhale with a sound. Letting go of anything that you've been holding on to. Inhaling, opening, receiving, releasing. Ah. receiving joy, inspiration, love, exhaling all unlike that. One more time. And just swing down and let yourself relax forward into a forward fold. Soften through the knees and then hold onto your elbows and just gently swing and shift the weight from side to side, feeling the length of the back, the length of the neck, the length of the back of your legs. Feeling that surrendering into gravity with the whole upper body. Decompressing, letting go. Release the arms and then roll up slowly. Go ahead and close your eyes. Just let yourself feel the difference in your body already as you've begun to prepare your body for your practice. All right, and now one of our favorites, just to jazz things up a little bit, with the two-year-old grounding exercise. So again, most of you already know this, so what you get to do is just bounce a little bit, letting the heels bounce, letting the knees be soft, letting the hips be soft and easy and flowing, and then letting the ribs relax, letting your shoulders relax. Arms get to relax all the way down through the fingertips, and then jaw and face and neck. And then you get to make a sound only like a two-year-old knows how to do, and you get to do it in the way that is just releasing anything that has been holding in your body with an ugh kind of sound, okay? So inhaling and maybe even swinging the arms up. Just letting it all go, letting your swing and your dance and your flinging anything out of your fingers, maybe even shaking through the feet and letting it all go. And then just pause and feel that in your body now. So I highly recommend the breath of joy and the two-year-old grounding as ways that you can, again, break up your day, add that in to wherever it is, however it is, and of course within the company that can join you, all the better. You know, to do the two-year-old grounding with a family can be a really great form of practice and good medicine for all. All right, now the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna step into a couple of power poses. So the first power pose that is familiar to all of you, which is the V victory pose. So we're gonna start with feet shoulder width apart and extend the arms up into a V. And let yourself feel that sense of rising up from the chest, lengthening through the fingertips, pressing down into the feet, all four corners of the feet, and extending up through the fingertips, feeling that sense of yes, victory. And you can congratulate yourself on one level right now because you're doing yoga. Congratulations, you opened up this YouTube video and you're doing yoga with me. Yes, victorious, you did it. You did it. So feeling that sense of that might be a small hurdle for some, but it might be a big one for others. So let yourself extend through and feel that V victory pose of success, of accomplishment, of a sense of victory. Feeling that in your body. And then from there, let's turn the feet out slightly. And then rotate the hands so that your palms are facing up towards the sky. Fingertips facing each other, and you're gonna peer or gaze up in between your fingers, gazing up at the sky. As you do this, lifting yourself up through the shoulders and chest, and also feeling that sense of your belly being strong and vitality emerging from that deep belly place. This is the Happy Buddha Pose. And the Happy Buddha Pose is a feeling of, or can stimulate in the nervous system, the feeling of happiness, the feeling of yes and content, the joy and delight of dancing with the palms up toward the sky. All right, and now bringing the arms down, turn the feet again once more out a little bit wider so you're really at the edge of the mat. We're going to bring our legs so that they're pressing down. Feel that sense of pressing out to the outsides of your legs so that you're not kind of rolled in, but you're pressing down and out, okay? Then feeling that sense of alignment of the hips. Remember, yeah, a minute or two ago, I was talking about that movement of the tilt of the pelvis. So let yourself tilt the pelvis under so that you really feel that tailbone going straight down like your tap root is firm. And then feeling your feet, maybe splaying the toes out a little bit and letting them rest down. Feeling that sense of anchor through the heel, both the inside and the outside of the heel. So you feel the strength and the support of the legs. Excellent. Now from that place of groundedness in your lower body, go ahead and place your light, gentle fists on your hip bones. As you do that, press down. As you press down, lift the chest up slightly, opening up through the front of the chest, just drawing the shoulders back slightly. So you're bringing your shoulder blades just a little bit closer together as you draw your elbows back. Not so that you're pressing the chest too far, but just so that you feel that sense of down, open, and back. Yes. So you've got legs active, you've got chest open. You've got length through the spine, all the way from the tailbone up through the crown of the head. And feeling that sense of confidence. This I call Wonder Woman. This is another power pose that, again, if you need a little amping up, do a power pose and feel the length and strength of your spine. Feel that sense of, yes, I can. I am here, I am present, I am capable, I am here, present, now. This is one of the biggest things that we were talking about with that story at the very beginning, is present, centered awareness. To not be in the future, to not be in the past, to be in the ever-emerging now with confidence, competence, and presence. So that's what this Wonder Woman energy can be for you in your life right now, to bring you back to that place, not from a not caring, don't know, we'll see, but from a place of wonder, curiosity, we'll see, don't know, letting go of the thoughts that we've thought before and open to the emergence of what can happen now. I wonder, I wonder. All right, feeling that in your body, let's just shake that out, shake it out, shake it out, and then find your ball. If you have one of the Gertie balls, go ahead and find your Gertie ball. If you don't have a Gertie ball, you could use a block if you want to. This is one of my blocks here. You could use a block and place it between your legs to be able to keep that sense of awareness of that midline. Or actually, you could use something that's the right width for you to be able to cinch the legs but still have your legs parallel hip distance apart. Okay, so here we go. I'm gonna use a ball because I love that. And I know that many of you have balls. So, this kind of ball, huh? Anyway, so feet parallel, hip distance apart, and feeling that sense of, again, grounding through the feet, all four corners, grounding down through the center and pressing out as you feel that squeeze in through on both sides of the ball. So we wanna make sure that our toes aren't turning in or turning out, and that your knees aren't knocking in or turning out. So you feel that equal squeeze on both sides, front and back of the ball. Okay, so once you've got that lower body going, see if you can keep it humming, because we want to keep it activated as we engage the upper body. So now, arms are going to reach up overhead, interlace the palms, or interlace the fingers, and then index fingers pointing up. Now, try this a little bit just to feel like you can get your shoulders in the right place. We're going to reach up, bringing the shoulders up towards the ears, and then let them slide back and down. So you really feel that sense of lengthening through the back of the neck. So the neck is really easy and has no holding or effort. In fact, actually, you may even want to let go of your jaw too. So all right, letting yourself feel that sense of strength and length of the spine, but also to be relaxed in through the face and through the neck. All right, this is mountain pose. So we're feeling that sense of the strength and support that is the infinite support of the earth. And really, she's always there for you. Mother Earth has gotcha. She's got her gravitational force and she is hugging you all the way down into the core, lava core of her center. So feel that sense of that line. No matter where you are standing on the planet, there's a direct line to the center of the heart of Mother Earth. So feeling that tether going all the way down and through you into the Earth center, supporting you, holding you, and you can let go into that support that's there for you. All right, from here, we're going to release the arms just to give them a little bit of a time out, bringing the hands to the thighs, close your eyes, and just feel the difference in your body already. Feel the difference, maybe your heart's even beating a little bit faster just with the engagement of your lower body in this way. All right, opening eyes again. We're going to bring the arms up and over into temple position again. And then we're going to go into half moon. So you're going to inhale, lifting the elbows up, lifting the shoulders up, and exhale, sliding them back and down again. Long neck, easy flowing neck, standing firm into the lower body. Lift up slightly with the inhale, but don't elevate the shoulders. Let them still rest back and down on the ribs. And then inhaling and exhaling over to your right. So you're feeling that length of the whole left side. And it's a direct side move. So don't curl forward with this. Instead, lifting up and directly over to the side. It may be that you don't go as far or feel like you're going as far, but that's not what's important here. What's important here is to get that place where you just meet the edge of the stretch that's there for you on your left side. And then you use the breath to encourage opening, to deepen into the stretch with the breath rather than the movement sideways, movement in between the ribs, feeling the strengthening that's also available as you hold the posture in that gentle stretch. And then inhaling back up and settling back down again. Now before we go to the second side, see if you can feel the difference in between or between the two sides. It's a good thing to pause, to pay attention, to notice what's happening in your body with these apparently subtle movements. There's huge shifts that are happening in our physiology and our biochemistry. Right, inhaling, exhaling over to the other side. So you feel that settling into the stretch that's yours on that right side. Breathing in and think of lengthening up and over. So this is an arcing over and not a collapsing bending necessarily, or it's not a hinging, it's an arcing up and over to your left side, stretching that right side out. Breathing in and feeling the expansion of the stretch through and in between the ribs. Again, feeling that sense of strengthening that's going on along with the stretching. Strengthening the musculature of the core, stretching the shoulders, stretching in between the ribs. Okay, now let's come back up. And then releasing with the exhale down to the thighs. Close your eyes and just feel that in your body now. That's it. All right, from here, we're gonna extend the arms straight out from the shoulders. And then check and make sure that your knees, as you move forward and let the knees soften into a standing squat, that your knees are tracking forward. So you're not knock-kneeing and you're not turning out. Your knees are going straight forward over your toes and shoulders and arms are extended. And then letting yourself slide back down like you're sliding down a wall so that you're not arching forward at this point, at least, and not arching back because that's a little tough on the back. So let's just slide straight down. As you slide straight down, you'll start to feel a place where you settle in because basically the backs of your lower legs say, nope, that's about as far as I can go. So you hang out there, wherever that is for you. And then feel yourself gently, kind of like you just did for the half moon, that you settle in to the bottom of that stretch, wherever it may be. And then when you settle into the bottom of that stretch, you find that place of strengthening. Can you feel that? Like now your thighs are probably starting to say, hello. They may even, depending on your legs today, they may even be trembling a little bit. They may even be shaking a little bit. But letting yourself just feel that strengthening happening. Not to resist it, but to breathe into it. Standing squat is a focusing and willful pose. So it's helping you become even more focused and meeting the edge of the strength of your body. All right, now we're gonna press up into the floor, bringing the hands down to the thighs and close your eyes. Oh, just feeling that in your body. Strength building in your body. Okay, now we're gonna do this once again, but this time we're gonna press into the balls of the feet. So you're bringing the arms up, and then find a visual focal point for yourself. Something that'll help, something that doesn't move, so that you can focus on it and help to stabilize yourself visually as you press into the floor, coming up onto the balls of the feet, lifting your heels, bending your knees, and then softening into the standing squat that is with your knee, your heels lifted. So feeling the lift of the heels, pressing into the toes, maybe widening out through the toes and feeling that stretch as well as kind of width that creates a little bit more support for you and your feet. Feeling the strength, feeling how your lower legs are more engaged now as you press into and lift the heels up, maybe even a little bit farther. Great, keep on breathing. Feel the strength. Feel the focus, feel the fortitude, press into the floor, lifting the heels up even higher, and then let them settle back and down. Hands come down, resting, touching the thighs, close your eyes, and just feel the difference in your body now. All right, now, if you are using the ball or a block or whatever it is, you go ahead and put that down. And put it to the side. Here, put it there. Stay. Okay, so from here, now we're gonna, I've got my mat set up so that I've got one this way and one that way. You might not, but at this point, I just wanna be able to pose in these, or put myself in a position for each of the poses that is easiest for you to see me. I know in a classroom it's a little different because I'm kinda, you're shifting around and focusing on your point of reference in a different way. Nevertheless, just follow along. So we're going to widen the stance. And we're going to turn so that your left foot goes to that wall and your right foot turns in about a 45 degree angle. We're going to go into a warrior pose, a variation on warrior. So the position of the feet is such that if I drew a line from the heel of this, of my left foot, or actually it's my right foot, but it'll be your left if you're mirroring me, and it goes to the instep of the other foot. That makes sense? All right, we're gonna extend the arms out, straight out of the shoulders, and then soften in to the left knee so that the knee is directly over or just back behind the ankle. Okay, so you feel that sense of strength into that stance. Press back and down into the right leg. So as you press back and down into the right leg, you engage these muscles a little bit more, okay? So as you press down and away with the feet, then you press down and away with the arms, feeling that sense of you're extending from core outward. Beautiful. And now, depending on, again, your legs, you may be feeling this pose as well. Strengthening your quads, gazing over the left fingertips and feeling that sense of alignment, as well as strength as you gather the energy of the warrior pose here. All right, from here, we're going to come down onto the left forearm on your thigh, raising the right arm up overhead. Feeling that stretch, you may even rotate your gaze over or up towards that right hand. And then if this feels like your version of the posture, you can do this. If it feels like there's more available, more strength in the core, extend the left arm and let it slide down. Palms are both away from you, facing away or toward me, and let yourself slide down. As you slide down into triangle pose, you're pressing the left elbow against, and left forearm even, against the left leg. So you're feeling that dynamic of pressing into the leg and the leg presses into the arm, and feeling that rotation and opening through the front. All right, from here, you can either, if you've already stayed with the elbow on the thigh, not coming up to the thigh, reaching up, rotating the arms. As you rotate the arms, go ahead and extend the front leg or your left leg and slide the right arm down the right leg as you come up. Gazing up at the fingertips again and then coming back down. As you come back down, let's just turn the feet and we're gonna go to the second side, okay? So turning right foot out, left foot in, finding that dynamic press against and away from each other as you shift the weight into the right knee. Again, the alignment here, you wanna notice the position of the feet as well as the knee over ankle. And then the position of the arms, we want the arms so that our extended arms are straight out of the shoulders. And then that feeling of extending down and away with the legs, down and away with the arms. Feeling that dynamic as you gaze over the right fingertips. And then falling forward, forearm on the thigh, bringing the left arm up, gazing at the fingers. If it's available to you and it feels right, extending the right arm, sliding down even a little bit farther down so that you're able to press against the leg, leg presses against the arm, gazing up, rotating and opening through the front of the left body. Feeling the strength, feeling the stretch, feeling the rotation. If you're on your thigh, then you can just stay there. And if you're not, come up to the thigh. And then we're gonna bring ourselves, extending that right leg, bringing ourselves up, extending left hand onto left, back of left thigh, and right arm up overhead, gazing up. And then rotating the feet, rotating the arms, either toe heeling yourself back to center or hopping the legs back to center, back to namaste. Pause for a moment, just feel the effects in your body right now. Now we're practicing, huh? Now you can feel your heart beating, now you can feel your legs starting to pump, now you can feel yourself starting to feel like, ooh, things are getting warmed up, right? Yeah. All right. So now we're going to step out wide again. And this time we're going to step out wide into opening up quads and thighs a little bit more, into alternating between goddess and star. Okay, so star, we start out with star, kind of like we did with victory pose at the very beginning, except for go ahead and feel that sense of your V expanding even more, like you're a radiant beaming star in the sky. And then also your radiant beaming star through your legs and toes, and your radiant star through the crown of your head and through the tailbone. So you are this six-pointed star that is infinitely extending into the world with your radiance, with your beaming light force coming out of the core and through every little molecule of your being. Shining star. All right, and then from the star, we're going to soften into the knees. As you soften into the knees, let the knees track back a little bit. So you're really opening up the inner thighs. Softening in through the elbows so that they come into a position that feels straight out of the shoulders and feels like you are now opening through the chest, lengthening through the crown, and sinking down so that you're able to feel this sense of openness through the top and connection through the bottom of the body, or through the lower half of the body. Can you feel that? Can you feel the goddess energy, that goblet-like position that you're taking? The holy grail chalice that you are, transforming energy into matter as the goddess does. All right, from here, back up into star. Ah, extending up and through, and then softening into goddess again. As you soften into goddess, let's now turn it forward, palms down onto the thighs, and I like to walk out just a little bit farther, and sink down. Let the tailbone drop back and down. Let the shoulders come up to the ears a little bit. You can stretch out through the shoulders that way. And breathe into this as you shift your weight from side to side. This is the sumo pose. So letting yourself shift from side to side, feeling it opening in through the lower body, opening down and through the pelvic floor, opening down and opening through the insides of the legs. Okay, now we're gonna just twist with this. So we're gonna inhale center, lifting up slightly. Inhale, then rotate, gaze over the left shoulder as you come back down into a spinal twist. And we're gonna follow the breath this way. Inhaling center, exhaling, shifting the left shoulder forward, twisting. Inhaling, exhaling down. Inhaling center, exhaling down. Inhaling center, we're gonna twist to each side one more time. Exhaling down. Inhaling center, exhaling down. This next time you're gonna inhale center and sink center. This feeling, if there's a little bit more available to you, a little bit more of a stretch, a little bit more ease and flow, and then press into the floor, coming back up to center, bring the feet so that they're parallel again, and this time actually we're just going to soften through the knees, rolling down and forward. Let your arms hang down. See if you can straighten through the backs of the knees a little bit more than you did when we did the first forward fold. And then bring your right hand across onto the outside of the left ankle. And maybe placing your left hand back behind the ankle. And then just drawing yourself down into a deeper stretch. Forward fold. Then walk through center. And then cross over, left hand to the outside of the right leg, right hand to the back of the calf as you draw yourself down and forward into a forward fold, letting yourself feel that sense of length and opening through the whole back body. Then walking back forward, let's soften through the knees and then slowly roll up. Go ahead and toe heel the feet back to center. Bring your hands back to prayer position at the chest. Pausing and feeling the difference in your body right now. All right, from here we're gonna move into downward dog. And I'm just gonna rotate so that it's easier for you to see me as I'm stepping out into downward dog. So that you can continue to do it this way. So I'm gonna roll down and then place my front paws so that my fingertips are splayed, index fingers pointing forward, and really feeling that sense of bearing the weight all the way through, evenly through the palm, the heel of the hand, and fingertips. I'm going to walk my feet back, still parallel, hip distance apart, and then just shifting the weight back from side to side, just planting one heel down and bending the opposite knee, and then planting the other heel down and bending the other knee, and just walking through, stretching it out through the backs of the calves, through the back body. Now, as we prepare for downward dog, what we're going to do is become aware of the rotation of the inner elbow. So we want to have the elbows either facing each other or slightly forward, just slightly rotated forward. And then we're going to bring ourselves back so that the ears are parallel with those eyes of the elbows or the insides of the elbows. So your neck is long and relaxed, and you're lifting up now as you press into the front body. Lift the tailbone up. As you lift the tailbone up, you'll feel even more of a stretch through the lower back. And then let your heels drop back and down. As you drop the heels down, you'll feel even more of a stretch through the lower leg, maybe through the hamstrings, and stretching yourself even more. Now from here, if it feels like it's too much for you, you can always come down onto your knees to be able to kind of self-regulate in that way. Otherwise, let's shift the weight forward. And as we shift the weight forward into the front arms, we want to make sure that the hands are underneath your shoulders. And we're going to come into plank. Now again, if plank is too demanding for your body today, you can drop the knees. If not, let's hold on to plank and feel the sense of strength through the core that's emerging. Draw the navel towards the spine so you're feeling that engagement of the lower abdominals. And then let yourself press through the heels, lifting up the heels slightly, and then lengthening through the crown of the head. So you're really feeling the strength of core pressing into the earth through the hands, lifting up through the navel, drawing that in, and feeling even more length through the spine. All right, and now let yourself come back down onto your knees. All right, pause for just a moment here. We're gonna actually continue into this kind of downward dog dance. So what I call this flying dog. Some of you have done this before, but I don't think we've done it in a while. So flying dog is like this, and I can demo it and then you can try to do it because it's kind of hard to watch and do at the same time. Okay, so now I'm gonna press back into downward dog. And I'm in downward dog, and now for flying dog, what I'm gonna do is just place my right foot in just slightly, and then I'm gonna lift up the left foot. As I lift the left foot, I'm gonna draw toward my spine or toward my navel. And then I'm gonna extend back behind me. And then I'm gonna extend out to the side. And then I'm gonna draw the knee in. Extend back and down. So the movement is either in a downward dog Or you can do the same movement on all fours, extending the leg, or actually we started drawing the knee to the chest, then extending the leg, then out to the side, and then down, back, and knee down. Okay, so either downward dog or on all fours. Okay, so let's do it together, and we'll start, I'm gonna just start with the other leg. So pressing back into downward dog, drawing the knee in, extending back, drawing the leg out, drawing in, drawing back, and down. Other side, knee in, leg back, open out, knee in, open back, leg down. And one more time each side. In and back and out and in and back and down. If it's too much, you can always come back to all fours. In and back and out and in and back and down. All right, go down with the knees and shift back into child's pose. Let yourself widen the knees out a little bit. So you have a wide knee child's pose, letting your body fall forward into the earth, extending the arms out, surrendering. Letting go. And then from here, go ahead and walk your arms out so that they're over toward me. And then surrender back and down. Let the opposite hip drop back and down away. Feeling the side seam stretch that's there for you. And then walk the hands back and over to the other side of the mat. And cross the arms and let yourself sink back with the hip away from the hands, giving that side seam a nice stretch. And then walking yourself back to center and down onto your belly. Okay, so from here, we're gonna just come down onto our belly so that you're able to extend the legs out behind you and feel that flat top of the foot flat on the mat, okay? So we're gonna bring up the squeeze, is what I say, bring up the squeeze in your glutes so that you're pressing down into the pubic bone and lifting that squeeze up into the gluteals. Hands are going to be underneath, so your shoulders or your elbows are directly under your shoulders, hands palms down. We're going to press into the floor and pull the arms toward us as we press down into the floor and lift up through the core, lengthening through the front body into Sphinx. Feeling that strength in the core, feeling that lifting through the whole front body. Keep on breathing, maybe even lengthening the space between your clavicle and your chin. And then roll down. As you roll down, let's bring the hands so that they're underneath our shoulders. We're going to roll the shoulders back and down so your elbows are tight to your ribs. Then we're going to extend through the legs again, just activating the lower body again by pressing down into the floor, bringing up the squeeze in the lower back and buttocks area. And then lift up with the head. As you lift up with the head, notice how I can actually lift my hands up and it's still, I'm using just the musculature of my spine to lift my head, all right? And then from here, again, we're rotating shoulders back, elbows tucked close to the chest, fingers splayed, pressing through the whole hand, both hands, as you gently lift yourself up just a little bit more into Cobra. Lengthen through the front body, maybe shifting the gaze upward. Notice how my elbows are still bent.
so that this isn't about extending too far. It's about feeling that place again where there's stretch and strengthening happening simultaneously. And then coming down.
As you come down, turn your head to one side. Bring your arms down to your sides. Let's bend the knees and just crisscross the legs back and forth behind you. Now maybe turn your head the other direction just to even out the stretch on the neck. Crisscrossing back and forth. All right, extend the legs. Go ahead and bring your hands underneath you. Press back and press back into child's pose again. As we press back into child's pose this time, see if you can have your knees so that they're close together instead of splayed out wide. And then just bring your hands back behind you so that you're extending palms up, tucking the chin to the chest and resting the head and neck down. If you can touch, then touch. If you can't, either the option is to bring a block or a blanket for your head and neck to rest, or you can even stack your hands and support them, or support your upper body that way. Wherever you are, let yourself surrender into the earth. And again, let's practice that idea of letting thoughts arise and letting the breath be a way of saying, let go. Inhale, don't know. Exhale, let go. Into the earth. Into the Mother Earth supporting you. Infinitely supporting you, all the way down to the core of her center, holding you with the gravitational force, hugging you. All right, letting yourself roll up back, sitting on your heels if you can. If not, you can come up sitting back by lengthening through the front of the legs. And then I'm just gonna turn myself again to right myself in relationship to you. And we're gonna start with a hamstring stretch, but also this is a spinal twist or moving toward the spinal twist. Extend the right leg out in front of you and then draw the left knee toward the chest. As you draw the left knee toward the chest, firmly place your foot on the floor so that you're feeling that sense of contact all the way through heel and ball of the left foot. Now notice, are you on both sits bones? See if you can get yourself to be on both sits bones and then extend through the right heel. So you really feel that sense of the pressing that leg down, lengthening through the whole back of the right leg. Now you can see I'm holding on with my hands onto my right, or my right, but your left knee. And then the option here is to hold ourselves into a sage position, so holding onto the elbows, hooking that around the knee, lifting up through the chest, lengthening through the crown, and feeling that sense of pressing down into the left heel and pressing out and away with the right heel. So you've got a lot of dynamic stretching going on, pulling in, pressing down, extending out, extending up, and pulling in at the same time. Excellent. Feeling the strength of sage pose. All right, from here, we're gonna release the arms and then cross the left leg over. So as you cross the left leg over, see if you can position it so that it's evenly placed on the floor alongside your right thigh. Right arm hooks around that knee, or right hand hooks onto the outside of that knee. Whatever's available to you, because either way, you're gonna feel a stretch through the outside of that left thigh up into the hip, right? All right, now we're gonna reach back with the left hand, just supporting ourselves so that we're not leaning back, but we're upward through and lengthening all the way through the crown and feeling that sense of pressing down into the left arm as you lift up, and then you're gonna gaze over your left shoulder. Continue to extend through the right heel so that you're lifting up and rotating and giving yourself a nice spinal twist. As you do this spinal twist, feel how every breath can give you another opportunity to lengthen and rotate, maybe just a little bit more each exhale. All right, release the hand, release the twist, and then cup under or around the knee with the outside of the left arm, and then hold on to the heel with the right hand. And what we're gonna do is just rock the hip. Now, depending on your flexibility and hip flexibility, you may be able to hold that with both elbows around the heel and around the knee. Otherwise, it could be that you cradle with your hand. Whatever feels right, given your flexibility in your hip today, just rock-a-bye, baby, with that hip. Feeling the flexibility that is there for you wherever you are today, without judgment about yesterday or today or tomorrow, just noting what is and letting go into that. Yeah. All right, now let's extend that leg out. As you extend the leg out, just shift your weight back and forth from side to side, feeling your sits bones both on the floor again, and then just feel the difference between your left and right leg. Pretty cool, huh? Feeling that subtle difference, or maybe it's a big difference depending on you. Okay, so now we're gonna do the same thing to the second side. So drawing the knee up, right knee up, come into that sage position. Sits bones are both on the floor. Pressing down into the left foot and heel. Pressing out and away with the, right heel and pressing down and away with the left. Hooking it into your version of the arm position for sage. Lengthening through the crown, opening up. And again, that dynamic contrast of pressing down into the right foot, pressing away with the left foot, lifting up out of the crown, pulling in with the hands or arms, and feeling that sense of openness through the chest. Yes. Sage self is what we need right now. We need to call upon the part of us that can be the wise one, that can be like the old man in the story, the one who says, I don't know, I wonder, we'll see, don't know. All right, let's release that and then cross the leg over. So we cross the leg over, again, we wanna feel that sense of pressing down into the earth with that foot. Extend away with the other foot, hook around with the left arm or on the left hand, and then placing the right hand back behind us, lifting up again, centering yourself, aligning the spine one more time. And then rotating with the exhale. So we're lifting up with the inhale, exhaling, rotating, gazing over the right shoulder. Every breath, just a slight opportunity to soften through the twist and deepen the twist with the exhale. This isn't about cranking, it's just about allowing and opening, right? Lifting, allowing, opening. Releasing that and coming back to center. We're gonna lift the leg up, holding on either to the heel or onto the inner arm, and rock-a-bye baby. Opening up that hip, lengthening through that hip. Yes. All right, let's return that leg out and see if you can extend. Just flexing the foot, pointing the toes, feeling that sense of sits bones on the floor. And then lean back, and let's draw the knees up, and then just windshield wiper them back and forth from side to side. Just releasing anything that's going on that might have been holding a little bit more in those hips of yours, letting them go. And in the shoulders as well, letting them go. Letting go. Mantra for the week. Don't know, let go, let go. All right, so from here, we're gonna work with the core a little bit. So a couple options. You can either use the ball meaning this ball, or I'll show you in just a second. The other option is just to even place your hands underneath your hips or your pelvis. But let me show you the ball first. So, all right, so we're gonna come down so that our feet are parallel, hip distance apart, just far enough so that if I reach down with my hand that my fingertip just barely touches my heel, okay? So you press up from there and place the ball underneath you. Okay, so the other option is to slide your hands, palms down, right next to each other, kind of like that, underneath your hips. And then you just sit on your hips, or you sit on your hands, I mean. Sit your hips on your hands. Okay, so I'm going to do this with the ball because I think it's fun. And it's also a little extra challenging. So, and I'm game for a little extra challenge. Okay, so now place the hands down on the floor, palms down on either side of you. And now from here, what we're going to do is lift the heels up so that we're bringing the feet up so that, again, knees are over hips. And you're going to extend the legs out just far enough so that you really feel like you're engaging your abs. Okay? And that'll be different for everyone. It'll be a little easier the more you bring your knees in and a little bit more challenging the more you extend the legs out. Okay. So from here, what we're going to do is we're just going to drop one foot down and bring the other one up, and then the other foot down and the other one up. And that might be it for you. That's giving yourself enough of a stretch for your own muscle strength for your abdominals or your core. For those that want a little bit more, you can bring your arms up so you're having to navigate the balancing on the ball with the arms up. If you want to create even more wonderful instability, you can bring one arm down as well as that leg down and up. And then, of course, if you want even more, you get to extend both arms and legs and then back up. Wherever you are in your version of this, letting yourself feel that place where you're going slowly enough so that you can really sense how the muscles are working to keep you upright and to maintain the difference of the weight distribution and the muscle demand based on that weight distribution of extending legs and arms and drawing them in. Okay, this next time, let's just hold the legs out, hold the arms up, feeling that sense of strengthening through the core, and then drawing the knees in, and just rocking gently from side to side. Go ahead and place both feet down on the floor, lift up, whether your hands are under you or the ball is under you, let's put it to the side. Go ahead and bring the knees closer up to the chest and rock from side to side. All right, from here, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna stretch out the hips just a little bit more by bringing your feet both down onto the floor and then cross the left knee across so that you're creating a figure four pose. So you're letting the knee drop out wide and creating that sense of an opening through the inner thigh. Okay, then you're going to draw the right leg up, holding onto the back of that thigh. As you do that, you'll feel a stretch in through the left hip. So flex the left foot, you can flex the right foot too. Flexing the feet, allowing yourself to, that actually, with the foot flexed, it stabilizes and supports your knee so that you don't over-twist or overstrain your knee, which is really important for a lot of us who have had rotator issues or ACL issues in our knees. Okay, so drawing the knee up, you'll feel deepening of the stretch as you draw the knee up towards the chest. Just breathe into that and feel the stretch. Feel that moving through you. Oh, such a great stretch. And then soften that and cross the leg over. And when you cross the leg over, this is kind of going from into a ladylike, crossing your legs. But we're also going into another posture that's a variation on the hero pose, but it's a on your spine hero pose. So we're gonna draw the knees toward the chest. It depends on your flexibility in your hips. You may even want to hold on a little bit lower or even all the way down to your ankles, which I can't do today. So I'm just going to hold up closer to my knees. And then letting the knees, see if you can pull them slightly, creating even more of a stretch through the outside of the hip. As you draw the knee in, you'll feel even more of a stretch. Yeah, there you go. Breathing into that hero. And then from here, we're going to release the feet back down while still with the leg crossed over, okay? Now press your arms out to your sides, palms down, and you can go all the way out here. I need to get this out of the way. You can go all the way out to the sides so that your arms are parallel with the outs, with your shoulders. So you're just going straight out, like a T-square out from the shoulder. And then we're going to bring this knee across and down to the floor. So we're drawing it down to the floor. As you do that, you'll feel a big stretch through the whole side seam. And as if you keep that back arm extended behind you, you'll feel even more of a stretch through the front of the chest. So letting yourself come down, and it's probably unlikely that you can have both the knees down and the shoulder down, but just see if you can get them to be as much in that state of openness as is possible for you today. And then maybe even rotating the arms back a little bit more with the shoulder girdle so that you can gaze over that back arm, feeling a stretch all the way through, even into the neck. Breathe into it. And then shift the gaze back and press into this hand to lift yourself back up again. And then uncross the knee. Take a deep breath, just centering the pelvis again, lengthening through the spine. And what we're gonna do is do that same routine to the second hip. So remember, we started by drawing the foot up and into a figure four pose. Widening through the inside of the thigh, flexing the foot, and then drawing the knee to the chest so that you get a deep stretch in through the outside of that hip. Flex both feet, stabilizing the knee as well as creating even more of a stretch for yourself as you draw the knee even more up towards the chest. Feeling that deep stretch, enjoying it. Letting the breath enter in and helping you feel even more relaxation and ease in the stretch. All right, let's soften that, releasing the hands off the back of the thigh and then cross the knees over each other. From here, we're going to draw the knees both toward the chest and then also pressing them or twisting them away from each other slightly. So you're feeling that sense of opening through the outsides of the hip as you do that. And then drawing the knees even closer to the chest. Again, other option, depending on your flexibility, you can shift your hands down, farther down, and even down to the ankles, depending on how much flexibility your knees and hips have today. Mine are liking this. Yeah, so letting yourself feel that length through the back of the neck, length through the spine, all the way through the tailbone, opening up the hips. Okay, from here, we're going to bring the hands down to the sides again, palms down. We're going to shift the weight over so the pelvis shifts down and away. And the knee drops across, so you're really feeling that stretch all the way through the whole side seam of the body. Attempting to keep that shoulder down, palm down, and using the other palm to right yourself by just rotating the shoulders underneath you just a little bit more. Maybe gazing over that front arm, breathing in and feeling the stretch. This is a really deep and wonderful rotation of the spine. And you've done a number of spirals already today, both in standing and seated, preparing you for this deep stretch. Letting go. All right, from here, now we're gonna press into that back hand. As you press into the back arm, drawing the knees up, then let yourself uncross your legs. Draw the knees to the chest. Let's just rock gently from side to side. And then we're gonna take this into Happy Baby. Okay, so go ahead and find your version of Happy Baby. Now there are a couple different ways to play with Happy Baby. Actually, there's lots of ways to play with Happy Baby. You can hold on to the outsides of your legs. You can hold on to the outsides of your feet. You can hold on to the big toes. I like to interlace my fingers and my thumb around my big toe. And then just draw the knees toward the chest. As you draw the knees toward the chest, just gently rock from side to side. Now imagine that you actually did have the mind of the happy baby. And the happy baby is so present, so in the moment, that he, she is able to just feel the stretch. And there's really nothing else. There's no comparing to one leg to the other. There's no real like, oh, well, last week I could extend my leg fully and this week I can't. Or there's, oh no, the worry about next week. What will I be able to do next week compared to this week? Instead, the happy baby is just in the moment, in the experience of extending, bending, and maybe feeling the possibility of lifting the hips or dropping back down, just letting yourself unwind, unravel, undo anything that's holding on in your lower back, anything that might be holding on in you at all. Okay. Happy baby. Oop, there was a little pop of my hip as it extended. And then drawing yourself back up by holding on to the backs of the thighs and then just rocking up to a seated position. We're winding down now. All right, so you got a couple of different options here as we wind down. So you've got either the option, if you have a roller, this would be an ideal time for your roller. And if you don't, then you could, and here's a couple of options. So you can see over there in the corner, I've got a rolled up yoga mat. So you could lay down on a rolled up yoga mat. You could also use blankets, roll up blankets and place them underneath your spine. Or you can just lay back and down and just feel the support of Earth in its levelness, in its length to support you. Okay. We're going to go through the similar breath that we did seated at the very beginning of class. So go ahead and come to wherever, however, you're going to support yourself in this pose and roll back onto the spine. So the knees are going to be bent wherever, however you are. And then start out by just feeling the sense of the breath into your own belly. Breathing into your belly. Slowing the breath down so that you're able to really feel that sense of the spine lengthen and letting every vertebrae surrender into the earth. Now remember the breath that we did at the very beginning, where we brought our arms up overhead. And then we brought our palms together. And then we drew the palms down into the heart. And then we opened up with the inhale, and then we exhale the arms down to the sides. So that's the breath that we're going to do here. Breathing in, bringing the arms up overhead. Exhaling, arms to heart center. Inhaling, arms up, out, and wide. Exhaling, down to the sides. Continue this breath, and as you inhale, arms up and over. Letting yourself inhale the thoughts of future. And exhaling all that into the heart with a sense of surrendering into love. Inhaling, arms out into the possibilities of future. And exhaling down into that place of earth's manifestation in its wisdom. One more time, up overhead, possibility, landing, planting, seated into the heart, possibility, opening, exhaling down into manifestation, and then let's just slide off of the roller or wherever it is or however you've been supporting yourself. And then we're going to prepare for Shavasana. So for Shavasana, you may want to place the roller underneath your knees. You may want to bring a blanket and place it under your head, a blanket over your body. You may want an extra layer of clothing just to keep yourself warm. If you have an eye pillow, this would be a time for you to place the eye pillow over your eyes. Just bringing yourself into a position of relaxation that is supported so that you really can surrender into Shavasana. And Shavasana is the pose that they say is actually one of the most difficult poses to do because it actually requires a quiet mind and a quiet body. So I'm going to take a seat here as you find your way into your version of Shavasana. And as you settle in, let yourself just scan through the body. It's always a beautiful thing to scan through the body, starting at the toes and just working your way all the way up to the top of the head. Starting with your toes, you may want to wiggle your toes, just kind of loosening it up, maybe shaking out the feet or ankles, maybe shaking out the legs a little bit, letting them rock out, and then letting them turn out slightly, just so that you feel that slight opening through the pelvis and the lengthening through the tailbone underneath you. Now that the lower body is settled, see if you can bring the breath into the belly and letting the belly relax, letting your hips relax, letting your lower back relax. Maybe slightly rotating the shoulders back and forth until you're able to rotate the shoulders back underneath you, opening up through the front of the shoulders and opening up the arms so that the palms are facing up. In this position, we're in a place of receptivity. So letting your heart be open, and then letting the neck and the throat, even the front of the neck and the throat area, letting that be soft and open. Jaw relaxed, temples relaxed, eyes relaxed, even letting the eyes settle back into the sockets of the skull, letting your tongue relax. Jaw can become a little slack as you soften and allow even the muscles of the scalp, get to just let go. Following the rise and fall of the breath, let yourself find a place of ease. Gently returning to the rhythm of the breath, that is one that is not efforted, but easy flowing. Finding the rhythm that is the most natural for you. And then in your mind's eye, I just invite you to notice how the mind likes to create good and bad. The mind wants to judge. And especially in times of uncertainty and in a time of pattern interrupt, the mind wants to choose this or that through the lens of past and future. Notice that is the mind's preference of conditioning. And yet we have a choice. We have a choice to be with what is, without projecting future or comparing to the past. And instead, we can be simply with what is. Letting yourself in this moment be with what is. Resting into what is. And choosing now if there is a desire for something other than, open to it as a place of wonder, of curiosity, of don't know, we'll see. Let life surprise me. Let life bring me a dozen wild horses. Let life bring me opportunity, growth, possibility, healing. I wonder. So letting yourself, as you breathe into this moment, as you let go into the exhale, allowing yourself to say, don't know, we'll see, expecting to be surprised in the most wondrous way possible. To breathing into that and letting it fill you with its genius. Placing hands either onto your belly center and or on your heart center. And let's chant the sound of Om together 3 times, just sealing the deal with our wondrous self. Take a deep breath in. Om. 2 more times. Last time. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Jagatwan, I honor the light within you. May you know this place of don't know, let go, we'll see. What wondrous opportunity lies before us. Namaste. So letting yourself roll to your side, coming up into a seated position just as you were when we began. And taking a moment to bow to yourself, to thank yourself for being willing to practice yoga, to show up for yourself in this way, and to bow to the others that are part of your class, your virtual class right now, as well as those that are in the sphere of your home community, with gratitude for this time, for introspection, self-care, transition, transformation, and wonder. With gratitude for the worldwide experience of this time. Namaste.